What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. You guys probably seen that LS430 timing belt. It wasn't really a how-to video, just like an overview, I guess, because I didn't really show specific steps on what to do on the timing belt. But yeah, the LS runs perfect. No coolant leaks, no oil leaks, so that's good. And I won't have to worry about some maintenance for a while, I hope, crossing fingers. But yeah, today we're back. We're gonna do a little install video. Not really gonna go too in-depth again. If you watch other LS430 videos, it's just kind of like a transformation video at this point. We got my coworker's LS430, but it's a pre-facelift. We're gonna be doing some coilover install, throwing on his wheels that he bought. Some used wheels, but it's some name brand wheels, Superstar Leon Hardrick Gemuts to be specific. They're 20s. I think the rears will clear easily without any cutting or anything. Well, we won't know until we get everything on, but the front's probably gonna have to roll, especially with a fatter tire. They're 29.5, 20.10 halves, and then like high offset, so we'll see. But here they are. The LS430. My 430 ready. Looking shined up and clean. You can see the difference. Yeah, we're gonna take care of that today. Shouldn't really be a long install. I think the hardest part is gonna be taking out the freaking back seat of this car. The front's generally, you just gotta take out the sway bar links, take out the upper control arm, and then pull the shock out. That's usually the easiest way to do it, which I found. The rears is pretty simple. Take out the top hat mounts and the lower mount, and that's it. It slides right out. So let's get this day started. All right, this is it. LS430 in all its glory. Stock form, baby. Comparison. Get it popping. We got the BCs. These are the extreme lows, or whatever you call it. Single lower than the other ones, I think. I'm not familiar. Actually, one of our other friends had BCs on his GS. I mean, they're all decent for what it was, the price point and stuff. So I'm not a suspension expert, and I've never played with a lot of different brand names. But I think I ran across like K-Sport, Megan's. I used to run Megan's on my GS way back when. BCs, obviously Tiedemann. Obviously, I think Tiedemann is superior. Ride quality, build quality, customization. So yeah, you can spec almost everything out on Tiedemann, depending on your needs. We're gonna jack this car up and start the install. I think I'm gonna start on the rear first, so let's get it started. All right, obviously I'm not gonna go too in-depth of this install. You can go look up other videos online. You watch my previous vlog explaining how to install suspension in the LS430 when we bagged Christopher's car. First things first, take out the back seat. The bottom pops up in the rear. There's some bolts holding it in, so. Anyway, backstory of this car, it's completely bone stock. It's only got like 55,000 miles. My coworker bought it from our other coworker. He bought coilovers and wheels, obviously, and then he just blacked this thing out. Shit's blacked out. It's like nighttime, but we got the back seat out. Just gotta take out the top hats, and then I'm gonna jack the car up. Just like that, the rears are out. Coilovers are in. Just adjusted it like 10 rotations from the max. He said he wants to go as low as can. I know the fronts are not going to be able to tuck or go as low as possible, so I want the car to sit even, no rake. You want the side skirt sitting flat, even though the rear is going to tuck. That's just how the body line is naturally, so we'll see what we can do, but probably gonna have to adjust it. I don't know, we'll see. Try to put the rim on and see what the height is at. Like, this is what we're working with right now. Damn, these wheels look pretty good. I actually wanted these wheels for my GS before I bought my SP5s, but Superstar doesn't make 18 step because you would need a 17 face step to 18, and they're getting the SP5s. They only make these in reverse 19, step 20. I don't know if they make 21s. If you have a reverse 19, you have a 19 face, and you can step it to 20 inch wheel. So I didn't have it in 18s, but yeah, this thing looks good. Like I said, it's about 10 clicks raised from all the way down. The coilover is drooped right now, so when you get on the ground, obviously it'll go a little bit lower, but the fitment looks kind of tight. Doesn't really look like you need to shave the fenders right now, but you can for more clearance. If you hit a big bump, then it'll end up rubbing, but check it out. There it is. I didn't cinch up the coilover yet. We're gonna do the fronts first, and then we'll just dial in the ride height later. Doesn't look like you gotta shave the rears. You could probably go lower, but I don't know how low I can go in the front, so I don't want to crank it all the way down yet. We'll do the fronts real quick. We should dial in the ride height, and that should be good. We got the fronts in. Gotta torque some stuff down. Upper control arm is almost bottomed out. It's like an inch from the top. So I don't think this thing is gonna go this low. It's pretty low too, so we'll see when we get the wheel on. All right, we're gonna have to roll these fenders because these tires are way too fat and it can't even go on right now. And I cranked the coilovers like 50 turns up from where I had it. All right, guys, we got the front, this side done. I might have to raise it a bit, but we'll see when we get on the ground and adjust it later. But I had to crank it up a lot more. I'm 20s and these tires are thick. This is a 245 on a 9.5, so it's got a lot of meat on there. Maybe if I had a 225, it'd be a lot easier. You could go lower, but yeah, I rolled the fenders. That's what's taking the longest. Kind of intricate and you don't want to fuck the fenders up. So yeah, just gotta go little by little. But yeah, we just gotta do the other side and then wrap things up and then dial in the ride height and that should be it. Hey guys, let me tell you, the front was a bitch. The rears are maxed out. That's the lowest it could go. I thought these were the all super lows or whatever, but I guess that's the lowest it could go. The fronts could go a lot lower, but man, I had to raise it up like freaking 5 times. I was going like 30 turns at a time. I didn't know that this thing has so much droop. I guess because it's a 10K spring rate. It's drooped in the air, and then when you drop it, it freaking collapses so much. But yeah, I think I gotta raise the front. I mean, if a guy was driving this, no offense, but they could kind of drive more careful. But when this thing is full lock, fucking sitting right on the tire. So check it out. So if his girlfriend's gonna drive it, he says she doesn't really care when she drives, so she kind of drives just like, not really reckless, but you know how they just rush out of potholes and shit. Yeah, I might have to raise this up a little bit. If this thing is full locked and you hit like a pothole, you're gonna bake in your fender, but I mean, it clears, it's pretty tight. This side's a little bit higher. I adjusted that side a little bit higher because when someone's in the driver's seat sitting down, you wanna compensate for that. Guys, we got it dialed in. This is pretty much the ride height. The front, like I said, has a meaty tire, so that's the lowest it could go. And the rears is maxed out, so I thought these were the super lows, but that's all it can go. Check it out. That's it guys for that install. Looks pretty good for a simple install. Nice wheels, decent size. I'm gonna just take it for a test drive. I torqued everything down to spec, so I wanna make sure nothing major is rubbing or anything. But yeah, stay tuned for the next vlog, knows when. Actually, he's got another LS too. Maybe that'll be on the vlog soon. Just stay tuned for that. Peace out guys.